In this video, I will give you a short overview of the Prism pipeline. Prism will automate the complete workflow of your animation or VFX project. We will start by creating a Prism project, then we will create assets and scene files. We will export objects between different software packages, and finally, we will render out a shot and create a video file from that. In this demonstration, I will use 3ds Max, Maya, and Houdini, but you can use whatever software you like, which is supported by Prism, to follow this demonstration. To download Prism, go to prism-pipeline.com and go to the Downloads page. I already downloaded Prism to my desktop, so I can execute it from here. To install Prism, you only need to follow the instructions of the installer. During the installation of Prism, this window will pop up where you can select which components of Prism you want to install. By default, Prism detects which software you have installed on your system, so the default settings should be fine in most cases. But if you want to install Prism for a different Houdini version, for example, you can double-click the path and select a different Houdini version. I click Install and wait for the installation to finish. After the installation, we can open an existing project or create a new project. And here we can enter a name for our project and a path where we want to save it. When creating a project, there are some more options, but for this tutorial I'm not going into detail. You can read the tooltips for more information. But for now, the default options are fine and we can create the project. Now we want to create our first scene file, and we can do that in the project browser. When you open the project browser the first time, you have to enter a name, which is used to identify who created a scene file. Now we are in the Prism project browser, and here we can create assets, shots, and scene files, and later on we can also compare renderings. In this tutorial, we will create an antelope walking through an environment, so the first thing we want to do is to create an antelope asset. We do this by double-clicking in this asset hierarchy, and here we can create an asset or a folder. Folders are used to group multiple assets, and I will create a folder called character. And when I double-click the folder, I can create a subfolder or an asset in this character folder. And here I create my antelope. And when I have the antelope selected, I can double-click in the steps list to create a new pipeline step, and I will start with a modeling step. And now I can right-click in this files list to create a new scene file, and I will create an empty 3ds Max file, and I can open it by double-clicking this version. Here we are in 3ds Max, and the scene is already loaded, so we can close the project browser, which opened on startup. We can start now to model our antelope. And to save a new version, we can use the Prism menu up here and click the Save Version option. We can open the project browser to see our versions. And there's also an option Save Comment, which lets us add a comment to our scene file so we can remember later what we changed in this version. And now in our project browser, we can see our new version with the comment. I finished the modeling of my antelope here, and now I want to export it to Maya, where I want to rig it and animate it. Imports and exports in Prism are handled by the State Manager, which I can open from the Prism menu up here. And in the State Manager, I have two lists, one for import and one for export. In each list, I can create multiple states. For example, in the export list, I can create an export state by clicking on this button. I also can create states through the context menu, for example, a playlist state. And when I select a state in this list, the parameters are shown on the right side of the state manager. For now, I only need the export state, so I delete my playlist state. And here I have to set a task name for my export, for example, antelope geo. And only objects in this list are exported, so I will add my antelope here. And now I have to publish my scene. On a publish, all states in this export list gets executed. I add a comment, for example, first export, and press publish. Now this state was executed and I can switch to Maya. Here in Maya, I have a Prism shelf where I can access all my Prism tools. And now I want to create a rigging state and a scene file so I can rig my antelope. For that, I select my antelope, double click in the steps list, and create a rigging step. From the right click menu, I create a new Maya scene file. And now I want to import my object, which I exported from 3ds Max. And I can do this in the state manager. Here I can click on the import button to create a new import state. And this will open the select state dialog where I can see all my exports. Right now I only have one export and I can import it by double clicking on this version. And here is my antelope and I can start rigging now. I can save my scene to a new version by clicking the Save button in the Prism shelf. I finished the rigging of my antelope and now I want to import it into a short file where I want to animate it. For that I have to export my antelope rig and I can do this in the State Manager. Here I can create a new export state and set a task name, for example antelope rig. And I want to export it as a Maya file, so I can reference it into a short file. And I want to export all objects, so the whole scene. And now I can add a comment, for example, rig export, and publish my scene, which will export my rig. The next thing I want to do is to create a shot, and I can do this in the project browser. Here I switch to the Shots tab and create a new shot by double clicking in this Shots list. I can add a sequence if I want. I call my sequence A and the shot O10. I can set some more parameters, but in this example I don't need it. And here I will add an animation step and automatically creates a category. For example, if I have multiple characters in this shot and I want to have different scenes for background characters and foreground characters, I could use a second category, but I don't need it in this tutorial. Now I can create an empty file in the files list here. And now I want to reference my rig in, and I can do this in the State Manager. Click Import. And right now we are in the Shots tab, so we don't see anything because we didn't export anything from a shot. We have to switch to Asset and navigate to the Antelope. And here we see our Antelope rig task and the version, which is a Maya file. When we double click it, we get a pop-up, and yes, we want to create a reference. I will also add an environment in this scene, and I will use an environment from an older project. I can use the import custom file to select files which are not in the project yet. And here I have an environment where I want to animate my antelope in. Here I have a scene with an animated antelope. And now I want to export it to Houdini where I want to render it. Again, exports are handled by the State Manager. And I will create a new export state. I set a task name, antelope anim. And because I want to export an animation, I have to change the frame range here. When I check this global checkbox, the State Manager will use the frame range down here. And I only want to export the first 40 frames, which is fine. And now I have to select the object I want to export. And because I want to export it to Houdini, I have to use this option here. Maya right now is in centimeters and Houdini works default in meters. And with this option, Prism automatically handles this unit conversion. I set a comment here. And I can publish the scene to export my animation. Prism now gives some warnings because some assets are not in the project folder, but this is okay for now. And now I can switch to Houdini. Here in Houdini I want to create my render scene file. And for that I select my shot and double click in the steps list to create a render pipeline step. And I can create here a new Houdini scene file. I create a new GeoNode and call it Antelope. And I also create a second node and call it Environment. I can go into the Antelope node and open the State Manager. And I want to import my animation. I click on the Import button and here I can select the shot and select the animation I exported from Maya. I double click it to import it. And here I can see my animation. It's fine, the first 40 frames. And now I also want to import my environment. And I use the import custom files option for that because the environment is outside of the project folder. And because it's in the wrong units, because it wasn't exported with Prism, I have to scale it manually. But here we are. And now I can apply shaders to my objects. I added materials and a light to my scene, and now I want to render the complete animation. And for that, I will use the State Manager again. And in the export list, I will create a render state. I can do this by clicking on the render button to create a mantra or a redshift state. This will create a new node in Houdini, but I already have a redshift node here. I created it manually, so I will use a states from node feature to create my render state. Here I can set a task name, call it Antelope Render. And I don't want to submit a render job, so I can ignore these parameters here. And I have set up a few render passes in my Redshift drop already. And I don't have to set any output path, Prism will handle it automatically. The frame range I want to render is 2040. I set a comment. And when I publish my scene now, Houdini will render this state and save the images into the project folder. Prism displays some warnings here because I have some external textures, but this is okay for now. And now I have to wait until the render is finished. The rendering is finished and now I want to composite my render passes here in Nuke. Here I have a Prism menu and a Write Prism node, which we will use later. But first I want to look at my rendering. I open the project browser and when I select my shot, I can see all renderings down here, which were created from scene files in this shot. I created a second version with a different lighting and I can scrub the images here and I can also watch at different render passes. And when I double click a preview, I can open it in a V or in a different media player. And when I select multiple versions, I also can compare them in a V side by side. And for now, I will use the left version for compositing. But first, I need to create a compositing pipeline step. I double click in the steps list to create it. And I create an empty Nuke script. And the project browser closes because the default option close after loading is enabled. And I navigate to my rendering, which I want to import, and right click on the preview. And here I can import images. And this gives me different options what I want to import. I can import the current layer, but I want to lay out all passes. And this lays out all render passes and composites them together. So I have complete control over different elements of the shot. For example, I can lower the fog a bit or apply a color correction to the diffuse. And when I'm happy with the result, I can create a right prism node. And here I can set a task name, call it main. And now I can press render to render out my final shot. The rendering in Nuke is finished, and now I want to see the result. I can click on the Prism Tray icon to open the project browser. And here I can navigate to the task I created in Nuke. And Nuke created an XR sequence, which I can now import into my editing software. Or in this case, I want to create a video file from this. I can right-click on the preview and select Convert MP4. And this will create a video file, which shows up in the versions list. Here I can open in Explorer. And here I have a video file of my final shot. This was an overview of the Prism pipeline, but there are a lot more features which will speed up your workflow and make your life a lot easier. Prism is free, but if you find it useful, please support the future development with a little donation on prism-pipeline.com. You can also find the documentation and more tutorials there. Thanks for watching.